Hello everyone, this is Dr. Rakesh Yadav and you are watching my YouTube channel Home Science Education. Today we are going to talk about genetic engineering in plants.
Genetics became my all-consuming passion. I wanted to create the perfect species, one that doesn't just live on our planet, but one that makes it better for future generations. The power of genetic engineering technology is beautifully presented in this science fiction book, The Birth, Soulmate Prophecy, authored by Yashvina Heck. Let's extend our talk on genetic engineering in plants. Genetic engineering, sometimes called genetic modification, is the deliberate, controlled manipulation of the genes in a life form with the intent of making that organism better in some way or the other. You can say it is a process of altering the DNA in an organism's genome. This may mean changing one base pair like AT or CG, deleting a whole region of DNA, introducing a copy of a gene that fundamentally belongs to certain other organism. How does genetic engineering work? Is already been discussed at length in our classroom study. Today, we are going to talk on advantages of this beautiful technology, especially in plants. The biggest benefit of genetic engineering in plants is expressing good agronomic traits, like adding new nutritional traits, building disease resistance, or developing abiotic stress tolerance, including salinity tolerance and high or low temperature endurance. So basically, scientists engineer the plant genome to add on new features which have never appeared into them ever before. This is called gain on function. Sometimes plants are engineered to make the undesirable character disappear. This is called loss of function. Now question arises that such gene-linked traits or phenotypes can be obtained by simple breeding experiments. Then why do we go for genetic engineering? The answer is very simple, friends. Breeding is a very time-consuming process and offer little or no guarantee of obtaining any particular gene combination from millions of crosses generated. Also, certain undesirable genes can be transferred along with desirable genes through breeding, and sometimes one desirable gene is gained, another is lost. On the other hand, only genetic engineering can offer direct transfer of one or just a few genes of interest between either closely or distantly related organisms to obtain the desirable agronomic trait. That also means breeding can only transfer the genes within varieties of same species. However, genetic engineering can make it rose kingdom. But how? That means, what kind of experiments allow the scientists to carry out this cross kingdom transfer of genes? There are two basic approaches of gene transfer. One is known biological system, which include chemical or physical methods of gene transfer. The other is biological system. Let's elaborate this. You can use chemical like polyethylenamine, dendrimers, or chitosan to deliver a gene into plant system. So that's a chemical approach of gene transfer. Secondly, high voltage electric shock for microseconds can increase membrane permeability of a protoplast and facilitates DNA entry into the cell to integrate into the genome. That's physical method of gene transfer, known as electroporation. Another physical method is biolistic approach. Here in this case, helium gas accelerated DNA coated nanoparticles bombarded onto plant tissue, which penetrate deep into the cell and nucleus to eventually integrate into genome. This is physical method of gene transfer. We have both electroporation and biolistic equipment in our plant molecular biology laboratory of the department. I will demonstrate these equipments to you once the lockdown is over and we return back to the lab. But I can demonstrate you the biolistic gene gun through a bombardment video.
You like, share and subscribe the video so that whenever I'll upload the video, you will get an alert.